how to get closer to Allah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How to get closer to Allah. There is a verse in the Holy Quran, Surah Baqarah, verse number 2, where Allah says, Alif Lam Mim Zalikal Kitabu. Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fihi Hudallil Taqeen. So this is the wording that will help you to go closer to Allah. It says, this book is a guidance for those people who has a taqwa, and the taqwa is the one who guard their eyes, who guard their ears, who guard their tongue, who guard their nafs. These are the things where the shaitan goes inside and corrupt our soul. We have to stop the haram things, and we have to fulfill our obligations towards Allah. Like, for example, staying away from the TVs and staying away from the useless thing, guarding our eyes, stay away from the music, stay away from the frame mixing, all these things. And how do we go to close to Allah? By adopting the life of the Prophet into our life, and that would be helping more, and just spending more time into zikr. The more time we do zikr, it makes our heart more pure, and it makes ourselves to go more closer to Allah. And among all the best of the things, you do it, it's you wake up in the tahajjud time is the best time to go close to Allah, because we know from the hadith that every night Allah comes down and he says, who is the one who's going to ask me for forgiveness? Who is the one who demands something? Who is the one who wants something? Ask me, I'm here, I'm near to you. Even if you read in Surah Baqarah, verse number 286, where Allah said to the Prophet, when the Sahabas used to come to the Prophet, used to ask him, where is Allah and how would he listen to him? Then the Prophet asked him, and the Quran replied it, those who are asking question where is Allah, tell them I am near to them. Even the same thing repeated in a Surah Kaf, verse number 18, where Allah said, I am very near to your jugular. So Allah is always with us. So we have to just fix ourselves, and we have to fix our ibadah. We're doing ibadah, and especially we have to stay away from the forbidden things, because it is easy to do a good deed, but it's hard to save the good deed. Because what happened, like when we're doing a good lot of good deeds, you do a one good deed, by unknowingly all the good deeds are being cancels out. So we have to protect ourselves. What is finishing our deeds, which is erasing our good deeds, but rather we should erase our bad deeds and increase our good deeds. And especially we have to take a look at the Surah Baqarah, verse number 2, where Allah says, Zalikal Kitabu La Raiba Fihi Hudallil Muttaqin. This is the book of guidance for those who has the taqwa. And who has the taqwa? Guide your ear, your eyes, your tongue, and or your nafs. Guard themselves from something haram. Like, you cannot see a haram, you cannot hear haram, you wouldn't say backbiting, you don't see any negative cursing or singing or music or anything. And also from your nafs, do not let the nafs to bring up something bad imaginations or dirty imaginations or anything. This will protect ourselves, and it will make this will make our du'as more stronger.